Let us discuss the next property of exponential Fourier series. What is this property? Conjugation symmetry property. So very simple property. Let us see what is this property is. If x of t's exponential Fourier series coefficients are cn, then as the name itself indicates, if you take the complex conjugate of x of t, then its Fourier series coefficients are exponential Fourier series coefficients are c minus n star. So this is a very simple property. So let us prove this property. Proof. So first let us write the exponential Fourier series definition and take the complex conjugate on both sides. So that will be the answer. So therefore the exponential Fourier series of the exponential Fourier series of periodic signal x of t is, so what is simple formula as we have been writing many times, so what is simple formula, summation, so n is equal to minus infinity to infinity cn into e power j n omega naught t, so in the interval t0 less than t0 plus 2 pi by omega naught. So what we have to do, we have to take complex conjugate on both sides. Take complex conjugate, take complex conjugation on both sides. So let us write this, what is this written as? X star of t, complex conjugation of x of t is x star of t. So that is equal to keep n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. As it is cn star, if you take the complex conjugation, it will become cn star. Complex conjugation of e power j n omega 0 t is e power minus j n omega 0 t. So, as you can clearly see that this is not the definition of exponential Fourier series. In order to make this exponential Fourier series, we have to make minus n to plus n. So, for this purpose, let or put n is equal to minus n in the summation. So let us see thus, therefore what happens to the limits, summation limits, it will become plus infinity, it will become minus infinity. If you interchange the limits, the summation answer will not change. So therefore what you can write here, x star of t, so that is equal to summation limits minus infinity to infinity. So keep n is equal to minus n, minus c minus n star, so e power j n omega 0 t. So you can clearly check that, from this observation, if x of t's exponential Fourier series coefficients are cn, if you take a complex conjugation of x of t, that is x star of t, so then its exponential Fourier series coefficients in the summation are c minus n star. Therefore what you can write, x star of t's exponential Fourier series coefficients are c minus n star. So this is what you have to write. Next let us see the one more property, the seventh property, very important property, convolution property. So very important property, convolution property. So let us see this property. If x1 of t's exponential Fourier series coefficients are cn and x2 of t's exponential Fourier series coefficients are dn, then you have to write like this, x1 of t, so this star represents convolution, remember that very important operation, convolution, x2 x1 of t convolution with x2 of t's exponential Fourier series coefficients are, remember that convolution leads to multiplication, t cn into dn. So this is the very important property. So the convolution leads to multiplication of exponential Fourier series coefficients. Convolution is the very important mathematical operation on the signals. So we discuss more about convolution in the unit 3. So therefore proof, let us prove this, how to prove this. So before that, the convolution of x1 of t and x2 of t is defined as, remember that this is the convolution operation between two signals. The convolution is mathematically defined as x1 of t convolution with x2 of t is mathematically defined as, remember this definition very very important, integral minus infinity to infinity. This is the mathematical definition of convolution. Put x1 of tau into x2 of t minus tau d tau. So remember that this is a very 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 important mathematical equation of this chapter. This will come, this equation will come many many times in the this subject. This is the convolution between two signals, how this is mathematically defined. This is the mathematical definition of convolution of two signals, x1 of t and x2 of t. So let us change, so this is for periodic signals. I slightly change the limits of the integrals for periodic signals. For periodic signals, I slightly change the summation limits as x1 of t convolution with x2 of t. Just I take the limits 0 to t, but most of the times, in all the cases, we take these limits, but only for this property, to prove this property, I take the limits 0 to t, keep that inside as it is, t minus tau d tau. So therefore, what we want to find out? We want to find out the exponential Fourier series coefficients of x1 of t convolution with x2 of t. So what we have to do? So we have to just, what is the exponential Fourier series coefficient of this function? Just as, what is the, write the definition, 1 by t. So for this problem only I take the limits 0 to t, instead of t0 to t0 plus t, just take the limits once I get 0 to t. Just to substitute this function here, x1 of t convolution with x2 of t, so write in one bracket, into e power minus j n omega naught t dt. So this is the, just find, substitute this function here, so in order to find its exponential Fourier series coefficients. So first 1 by t, so integral 0 to t, so as I have defined the mathematical equation of convolution, so the mathematical equation of convolution is just I have taken the limits 0 to t, so x1 of tau, remember that x1 of tau, x2 of t minus tau, we have to integrate with respect to d tau, remember that, so write in one back bracket, so into e power minus j n omega naught t dt. So from this, let us write this integral 0 to t x1 of tau d tau in one integral. So that means I write integral 0 to t x1 of tau d tau in one integral and write the rest of the terms in one integral. So that is 1 by t integral 0 to t x2 of t minus tau into e power minus j n omega naught t, this term in one entire bracket. So this is dt. So this is dt. So put all these terms in one bracket. Now, so what is this formula? This formula is nothing but as the exponential Fourier series coefficients of this function, time shifted function, x2 of t minus tau. What is this definition? This is the exponential Fourier series coefficients of x2 of t minus tau. So as we have discussed previously, if x2 of t is exponential Fourier series coefficients are what we have defined, dn in the problem. What is the time shifted? X2 of t minus tau's exponential Fourier series coefficients are, time shifting property as we have discussed, just write minus sign, minus j n omega naught, instead of t naught, tau is there, tau, because x2 of t's Fourier series coefficients are dn. So therefore, this entire bracket is replaced by e power minus j n omega naught tau dn. So just write that. So therefore, I write integral 0 to t x1 of tau into, so what is this entire term can be written as e power minus j n omega naught tau into d tau into dn is a constant, take our dn right here, dn. So in order to make into the definition of exponential Fourier series coefficients formula, so just multiply with t and dn you take it outside, because dn is, take it outside, write it as 1 by t, so write it as 1 by t, so because t gets cancels out, 0 to t x1 of tau into e power minus j n omega naught tau d tau. So let us write it in one bracket. So what is this definition? This is the exponential Fourier series coefficients of x1 of t or tau, it doesn't matter, the entire answer will come into n. So therefore what is the, what we have taken, this is taken as cn. So therefore, so the answer is, the answer is t into cn into dn. So this is the very very important property. So therefore what we can write it as, x1 of t is convolution with x2 of t is exponential Fourier series coefficients are t into cn into dn. So this is the very very important property, remember that. Hint, I give hint, the convolution always leads to multiplication and vice versa. This is true vice versa. So the convolution in one domain always leads to multiplication in another domain and vice versa. So this is true for exponential Fourier series properties, exponential Fourier series properties. Next we will discuss Fourier transform properties in this chapter, Fourier transform properties for this in this chapter, Laplace transform. This hint is same for all these properties, Laplace transform properties, and finally jet transform properties. For all these properties, remember this very very important hint, the convolution in one domain leads to multiplication in another domain and vice versa. So this is about the convolution property.